problem, love. It's flake wrappers in the plug hole.
You can almost guess the age of someone by asking them which was their favourite flake commercial. You know, everyone has their particular favourite because it happened at a particularly, I don't know, adolescent time of their life.
Only the crumbliest flake is chocolate. Tastes like chocolate never tasted before.
Considered very sexy ad, just the whole sort of scenario around it and the phallic shape of the chocolate. Well, what can you do with it? I mean, you know, there's not much you can do with it. I got into a lot of trouble. This I only found out when the commercial came out, because when I bit it, I put my tongue on it, which was a no-no. But I didn't, you know, I just did what came naturally to me. I ate, I think it was about 40 of them, and I felt very sick over the period of 2-3 days. I got very sick.
The way that the flake crumbles is very important as well, and very significant. It has to crumble. Brushing of the flakes off the lip, absolutely essential. It appears in most flake commercials. So many legends and fables surround these films, but from what I can gather, the idea of the lizard or the gecko on the telephone came from the lighting cameraman, who said, why don't we add this touch of exotica? And it came to represent a lot more than that. Women said, yep, lizard, we like lizard on phone, and we're not going to tell you why.
The lizard wasn't there, unfortunately, because I rather like lizards.
The whole idea of loading a flake film with symbolism is quite a good fun thing as well.
Cadbury's Flake, the crumbliest, flakiest milk chocolate in the world.